Beyoncé is the queen bee of R&B, and that is nothing new. Can Beyoncé do any wrong? Her makeup is always perfect, so is her hair, so is her body, and so are her vocals. She is the definition of confidence and being flawless. She exudes perfection from the inside out, whether it be in her performances or as a lifestyle. Hey guys, welcome back to Daily List. My name is Azalea Hart. If nobody told you today, you look beautiful. Love what you got going on over there. We are talking all things Queen Bee today, so if you love Beyoncé, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and click subscribe. We don't get to see Beyoncé without her crown on very often, so it's a little fun when we see the sass come out. Am I right? I'm counting down some of Beyoncé's most diva moments and sometimes pretty shady moments too. So make sure you watch this video to the end because you're not going to want to miss one of these. To start off, I got to tell you guys about some of Beyoncé's most crazy, insane tour demands for the Miss Carter World Tour. Now this is the definition of a diva. Hand-carved ice balls to suck on, freshly painted white walls, and a new toilet seat. Red toilet paper, 100% pure cotton clothing for her staff, titanium drinking straws, and these cost roughly around $935 to drink special alkaline water served at exactly 21 degrees, and there cannot be any junk food anywhere. You don't just become a Beyoncé, you are either born with it or you ain't. And clearly, Beyoncé was. Beyoncé was born, Beyoncé. She's the Beyoncé-est Beyoncé ever, and yes, I just used Beyoncé as an adjective. It all started at a young age with the original Destiny's Child.
You are all right just on that. With all the children, you were kind of soft, but you are doing good.
Now we all know that Beyoncé equals Destiny, and the other girls in the group are her children, therefore making it Destiny's Child. Okay, I'm joking, don't kill me, Destiny's Child fans, but really, who's the lead vocalist here?
Okay, now, Beyoncé, I understand you are the leader, right, of the group? I sing lead.
Yes.
Oh. So do you all have, like, arguments, like sisters, at times when you have, you know,
we have arguments, but not about, singing lead or
No.
Because Beyoncé is the lead, do you think she was gonna let anyone else say that they're the second lead? This might as well have happened under a tree because it was so shady.
The fact that I'm the second lead vocalist of the group, and that's about it.
Mm-hmm. I'm Latavia.
Not long after, two of the Destiny's Child members were replaced, and how did those members find out that they were replaced? Well, it was when the Say My Name video came out and they weren't in it.
New Year's. We're about to go to Europe, and as soon as we get from Europe, then hopefully we'll get a couple days home.
And we're also gonna do our new video too.
That's right. Say My Name.
On the 27th of December, to be exact.
We were having problems for a while now.
It's just a real weird feeling to actually be with somebody since you were 9 and 10 and then be separated so suddenly. That's
what was that like, though, when you heard that they'd shot a video for a song you sang on without you?
I was like, you won.
They were very, very aware of everything before it was done. Can't get into it legally, but there had been comments on the radio stating that they knew exactly what was going on. I called them personally and said that I would be a bigger woman and call them and confront them.
Have any argument, Latoya and I, we never quit the group.
Never quit.
We never quit.
Never left, never even said anything about quitting the group.
They've got love for you guys. They do not have hard feelings for you. Their issue is with management and not with the two of you.
Well, they slapped a nice lawsuit on us.
Yeah.
So
that's a lot of love.
That's some hard love, isn't it?
Shortly after, Destiny's Child reemerged with their two new members.
Tell me this, obviously two new faces. What, first of all, what happened to Latavia and Latoya? Latanya.
Latoya and Latavia.
Right? And what happened?
Well, we're working on a settlement right now, so we can't really get into that.
My name is Michelle Williams. I'm 19 years old from Illinois. What's up, everybody? I'm Farrah. I'm from LA, and I'm also 19.
Now, it didn't take long for the foursome to turn into a trio, and Farrah was out. And Queen Bee made sure to let her know that she needs to leave with or without her luggage.
That's the last flight out of here?
Yes, ma'am.
You might have to go straight to the airport.
Okay. I don't have no luggage.
I'm rolling.
But it's better for you to go home than not have luggage.
No, it's not. Because where y'all coming out there? Well, somebody can send your luggage.
But then I'm gonna have to wait for 4 days before I get all my stuff.
It's either that or you gonna probably miss your flight.
She said she couldn't make it, and basically, when you don't show up for work for over a week, just like any job, you can't just not show up for no reason. Everybody was tired. We all were on the same schedule. Everybody was tired. I think she just couldn't take it.
And finally, Beyonce felt that Destiny's Child was complete.
All of the bad seeds are now out of Destiny's Child.
That's
we've
right.
had changes in the group, and we finally found the recipe that is perfect.
Moving on to some more diva antics by Beyonce. She is not about answering questions more than once, so reporters better come correct.
Solo activities, how do you feel is different from being a group as in Destiny's Child?
I'm sorry, but I answered this question already.
Oh, you did? Okay.
All right.
As Beyonce says, a diva is a female version of a hustler, so while she's on tour, she definitely hustles.
So if everyone sees that I'm tired, then they have reason to be tired. So I always pretend that I'm completely fine.
Tired?
No, I'm good. I've been running a couple miles.
That includes no sleep, no food, and pretty much being a robot for her and the rest of her staff.
When I work, I don't eat. I don't use the restroom. I'm like a machine. And I forget that other people have to eat and other people have to use the restroom.
And lastly, she's extremely particular when it comes to her set and her production. So basically, f*** your feelings.
This looks fine. It's boring, but it's whatever.
It's like placing the candles. Once you get them all in the right place, it all falls together.
Those candles don't look right. I think it might just be better without the candles. They're not doing anything for me.
Clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
So if you made it to the end of this video, obviously you love Beyonce as much as we do. So give this video a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe. We gotta give it up to Beyonce because there's never anything negative in the media about her. And people literally worship the ground that she walks on. If you know any diva that's bigger than Beyonce, make sure you comment down below and let me know who it is, and then maybe we'll do a video on her. So don't worry, Beyonce. See you guys next time.